What's up, guys?
So the Dragon Age Inquisition information series continues. Now remember, this information was taken from the PAX Prime panels that Nerd Appropriate posted on their website and on iTunes for people to hear the audio. So yeah, that was super awesome. Links will be in the description. The tactical combat is going to be throughout all 5 platforms. You could pretty much control the camera. You could zoom in, zoom out, boom, boom, move around and look at all these cool stuff. It's super exciting that they're introducing this to the consoles as well, because now everybody will be able to benefit from that. I mean, you don't have to use it. That's one thing that's a plus, because some people don't like that. Some people don't want to pause in combat and look ahead and prepare that way, because pretty much what they're allowing you to do is, like they showed on the demo, they are making it so that you could pause in the action wheel. You know, you could look around where you're not completely paused. Because you could still move the camera, but everything else freezes. Like, the enemies freeze, you freeze, but you could still move the camera and look ahead and see what enemies are ahead of you, or what you could use to your advantage. For example, anything around the environment, like bridges or columns, or, you know, are there archers further down there that are going to be trying to kill you from afar? So it that's why it's called tactical camera, because it involves this tactic. But if you're not that type of player where you're just like, you know what, I don't care, I just want to go in and beat the crap out of whatever is in front of me, you could do that too. You don't have to do the pause and look around and move the combat camera. I personally would use the tactical camera, because I like that idea. I like going into a battle, being able to prepare for it, being able to plan for it, being able to, like, to think of who I have with me and how to use them to their best advantage, or to your best advantage, and how to try to get control of the battlefield. So I would be using it, but if you don't want to use it and you just want to see the awesome animations of you beating the crap out of things, you could just do that. You could also switch characters. You were able to do this in Origins and in Dragon Age 2, where you could switch, say, to Varric if you want Varric to do something specific in a specific time in a specific area, and you don't want to use tactics like you could in Dragon Age Origins, where you could send them to specific areas, and Dragon Age 2 as well, where you could say, when this happens, when this type of enemy attacks, or when this type of enemy uses magic, you do this, respond this way. It's like inputting information to your characters or to your party members so that they could react in a specific way and not just react by the computer, you know, by default, kind of making it so that, I mean, they do react well, and they said that they're saying that party AI will support you depending on enemies and situations, but you also have that control. If you want to have more control over that, you could go in the tactics and give them specific tactics. That does take a long time, though. I remember with Dragon Age Origins and Dragon Age 2, but it proves to be extremely beneficial because of chain attacks. A lot of people have played Dragon Age Origins and Dragon Age 2 without, especially Dragon Age 2, because in Dragon Age 2, you could really take advantage of this, of chain attacks. A lot of people don't know about them. They don't know how to use them. They don't know what they mean. They're like, I don't know how to do that, because they could be a little bit confusing to people that haven't played RPGs in the past, or haven't played MMOs, because this is more of a this concept is more of a usual fighting style for MMOs, where your party, because you are fighting in parties, you're fighting with groups of people and different classes, you set up like a routine where it's like, okay, the warrior's gonna use a shield bash. When the warrior uses shield bash, that attack is going to cause the enemy to get staggered. And if the enemy gets staggered, the mage has to use a lightning bolt. And if when the lightning bolt hits the enemy while it's staggered, you get like this freaking crazy amount of damage, like 600% damage. So some people don't know how to do that. They're like, I don't know what the hell. If you remember Dragon Age 2, the enemies, when Shield Bash was one of them, if you had Aveline or yourself do a Shield Bash, I believe the enemy would get staggered and you would see these little lines above their head, like the different icons meant different things. If they have an ability that could take advantage of staggered enemies, if you just look in your abilities and it'll say that when staggered, you get 600%. It's like 600% damage, or it's like crazy amounts of damage. So the enemy will be staggered for a few seconds. So if you lose that time period, if you're too slow, or you don't have your party member with tactics, like you put Varric, like you're like, okay, every time I stagger an enemy, you could do this. You could go in the tactics, go to Varric and say, when enemy is staggered, use so and so attack, and this attack it should be something that takes advantage of staggered enemies. I don't know if this is making sense. It makes some more sense when you're actually seeing it. This is going to be returning for Dragon Age Inquisition, and it's really exciting because I loved doing that. I took advantage of that a lot, and I killed a lot of enemies that way. And you hear, once you nail that chain, you hear this like boom, and you see massive amounts of HP being lost by the enemy. That comes down to tactical combat, not just the camera, but tactical combat in general, because you're using tactics, you're pausing to think about it, and you're not just going in there and fighting. You could just do that. You don't have to use tactics, you don't have to do chain attacks, but you have to be prepared for a tougher fight if you don't take advantage of those chains that will give you an advantage in a fight, and maybe even have you kill enemies faster and that kind of thing. Not only do your party members have like a smart AI where they help you out given the situation that's going on, the enemies do too. The enemies work as a group as well. So the enemies also have their own tactics and their own support system, and their own class as well. They work with each other and they will try to take you down just like you're trying to take them down tactically. The level design also affects the fight, which is this is one of the biggest things added to Dragon Age Inquisition when it comes to the combat, is that you could interact with things around you, with the environment around you. And not just you, but the enemy can too. The enemy can break through like walls. They'll just like bash through the wall. They could break down your cover. Say you're behind something that's giving you cover from the archers. Another enemy could break it down, and you'll be exposed. So you could do that too, as well. You could, like in the demo, they were talking about this bridge that had archers on the top, and with magic, or I think you could do it with anything, with another thing, you could destroy the bridge and the archers fall to their death. Or you could put like a wall of ice. Your mage can make a wall of ice and give you protection, your protection from the archers. And you could position, say, Varric around the wall of ice so that he could be shooting at the archers or something like that. That's one of the reasons why the tactical camera can help, because it makes you look around, say, okay, those are the archers. Here are this is where the warriors are. This is where this is. Pretty much the whole tactical aspect just makes it so that you could end a fight faster than if you just went guns blazing. You could still do it. You could still do it guns blazing, without doing all this tactic stuff, but it most likely will take you a little bit longer, which is not bad, but it just has to do with the practicality of what you're doing and the effectiveness as well. There is no automatic health recovery. There is a limit to how many health potions you can carry. This can change depending on the level of your alchemists. Exploration is a huge aspect to Dragon Age Inquisition, but the big story is still there. Like I said in a previous video, in my previous video, the exploration is there to give you more to do or to enhance your experience, and not only your experience, but also your items, your crafting, what you do. If you go look for specific items, just doing that, just going to look for specific items, obviously you're gonna have things, items that you found or acquired in ways that other people probably didn't, because they didn't go out and saw they didn't go out to seek this specific creature to get what it dropped. You need to control the battlefield, can't play sloppily because you need to manage your potions carefully. So this is what I was saying about the effectiveness of a fight. You could go guns blazing, but you got to be prepared to know that you're probably going to have a really hard time taking a specific enemy out, especially if it's a higher level enemy, because enemies are not capped to your level. So you gotta go prepared because, like they said, you can only have a specific amount of potions. So if you run clean, if you run through those potions, you're dead because you ran completely through those potions. Let's say you have five. Let's say your limit is five potions, and you go to a high level level area, and you're not prepared. Or you just go in there and you fight sloppily, you're probably gonna burn through those five potions in like 5 minutes and you're done. So you just ran through five potions and you killed yourself and your whole party. Every fight is a risk and an opportunity. So they are going to be very challenging, the fights, but you will almost always get something from that fight. You will get items and XP. From specific enemies, especially if you're fighting something really tough, you won't just be killing it for nothing. You will get something from it. The inspector or the cursor that you move around in the tactical camera, when you hover over something that is destructible, like say the bridge, it'll say right there. It'll say destructible. So that's one reason why it's good to go ahead and look at the environment ahead of you so that you could see what is destructible and what is not. If you don't see anything that says destructible, then you won't be able to interact with that thing. But if you see things that are destructible, you could think beforehand and say, okay, I got it. I know what I'm gonna do now. I'm gonna take advantage of that and I'm gonna do this and that, blah, blah, blah. This inspector or this little cursor is also the way that you move your party members around, where you move ahead and you click for, say, Varric to move to that spot. That kind of thing. That's how you move your characters as well. Party members that fall in battle will get up after battle, but will be badly injured. So you need to plan if you wanna move on like that with your party members being injured. Or if you want to use your potions, or if you want to go back to your stronghold, because they will get rested and get healed and all that in your stronghold. So I really like that idea. I think a lot of people might be like, "Oh, really?" But I really like that idea because it makes you feel like you're there. It makes you feel like it's real. It gives you that sense of danger. It gives you that sense of like, oh my God, what am I gonna do? Like, I'm out here in the middle of nowhere. My party member is freaking hurt. What am I gonna do? You know, I love that feeling. I don't know what how you guys feel about it, but I absolutely love that feeling. That feeling of like helplessness and knowing that everywhere you go now from now on is probably absolute death. So you're going to be trying to avoid everything so carefully. You're going to be moving through the area so carefully because you're like, I need to make it back to the stronghold safely because I cannot survive another battle right now. I love that feeling. So I'm so excited about that. It's adding that extra emotion that wasn't really there in the previous games where you feel like you're in danger out there. And you're not just gonna regen your health. You're not gonna be able to craft your potions wherever the hell you are. There's no danger there. Say Varric has a gash in his head and he's got like low HP. I'll just give him an injury kit. We're probably gonna find one later on, anyways. Give him an injury kit. He's fine. Boom, full health. But no, now it's like I gotta go back to my stronghold because I can't waste my potion right now. I gotta go back to my stronghold, get more potions or whatever, or get Varric back in full health because I can't survive right now like this. And going through the wilderness like that, where you're like, I better not encounter anything right now because if I do, I'm so dead. I love that feeling. And then making it back to the stronghold safely, it's like, oh, and especially if it's nighttime because you will have daytime and nighttime cycles. If I remember in Dragon's Dogma, that was one of my favorite things about the game was traveling through the night. It was so dangerous because it was pitch black. And you're just like, oh my God, all you have is a little lantern and you're just like, I'm gonna die. Like where you're walking around and you're trying to stay away from anything that will aggro you, that will attack you. And you're just like, oh my God. And you hear noises out there and you're like, where is that? I love that feeling. I love that feeling. BioWare, if any of you are watching this, a little lantern, being able to carry a lantern, that would be awesome. And make it pitch black at night. It only adds to the feeling. I love that feeling. So here it is again. Tactical cam is not forced on you. The fights can be different depending on its intensity. Use tactical cam when you feel you need to. The party should be predictable and competent, meaning depending on the class of the party member, you will expect them to respond or react the way that their class signifies. For example, a healers should always stay away from the enemies, like in the back, and they should heal whoever's dying. You can't just go around destroying things. Like I said, things have to say destructible for you to do it. Because if they did that, people would just go around just bombing everything. If you're a mage, you'd probably just set fire to everything. Like, whoa! Everything that is destructible will have a reason to be destructible. You can't just break it down because you want to. So that's pretty much it for tactical combat. Hopefully you guys enjoyed that. Let me know what you guys think about it in the description down below. Remember, this is all optional, so you could play the game however you want. Don't get turned off by hearing all this crazy RPG talk. Don't be like, oh my God, I don't even know how that works. Click. For those of you that loved the combat in Dragon Age 2, and you didn't like the combat in Dragon Age Origins, I know a lot of people, that includes a lot of people because I have seen it. A lot of people saying, I actually enjoyed Dragon Age 2 better than Dragon Age Origins. And that's absolutely fine. It's just d different types of gaming styles. So that's why I'm happy that BioWare is making it an option for those people, because that way you don't have that tug of war, where in Dragon Age Origins, people are like, I don't like this type of combat. And in Dragon Age 2, those people that like that type of combat are like, what happened to that type of combat? You got both. In Dragon Age Inquisition, you could choose from both, except it's cleaned up, it's more advanced. And now, if you ever want to use tactical camera, if you ever want to, just for a little bit, if you're just like, you know, I need to know what's over there, you could do it. You could do it. You don't have to do it, but you could. And you still have those animations with your characters, where you see those awesome animations from your warriors or your mages doing their abilities or their spells, and those rogues pulling on those bowstrings that they finally have. So yeah, should be awesome. Let me know what you guys think, and I'll talk to you guys later.